Ladies and gentlemen, boys, welcome to Little Hope, just in time for Halloween. We played the game Man of Medan not too long ago, a decision-making horror-esque game where my decisions get people killed.
All right.
And this is not the sequel, but kind of like the sequel, Little Hope. And it's going to be sick. It's not like really a story sequel, it's just from the same makers. So don't play alone, play alone. I'm going to play alone because I'm sad and lonely. So Man of Medan had a really eerie story, and a good one, which I thoroughly enjoyed. I'm hoping that this game is going to be even better. If you haven't played or watched Man of Medan, I highly recommend that you do, because it was thrilling. It was an experience of a lifetime. I like it when your decisions have consequences. It makes it that much more emotional, right? You feel more invested in your decisions. And you feel a lot more responsible. All right, nighttime in the forest. It's always a good start. A creepy bus driver exits the diner. He's gonna hit a deer. I've seen this scene 100 times over. He's gonna hit a deer or swerve or crash the bus, anything. Come on, don't make me look bad in front of everyone. Also, no spoilers. I watched a trailer to this months ago. But nothing since. So, no spoilerinos.
Thanks for pulling over.
Sure. Something wrong?
We got a problem up ahead. A big accident. We've had to close the road.
You're right.
We're diverting all traffic through Little Hope.
He said the name
you
of the game!
Okay, buddy? You seem a little confused.
Yeah, I'm fine. I just want to get these folks to where they need to be.
I doubt a short delay will trouble them too much. Head up the East Road. Takes you straight through Little Hope. Adds almost no time to your journey.
Creepy bridge to a creepy town. Little Hope.
Any harder, it'll wear away to nothing.
Right.
How long have you been sober?
A few days shy of 3 months.
Impressive. I heard the first 90 days are the toughest and roughest.
I know it doesn't add up, but I get something from holding on to this.
We're going the wrong way.
It's fine, just a quick detour.
It's not fine.
Calm down. It's all okay.
Oh, please, John, could you not patronize me?
Can you keep it down, please?
Bearing updated. What's the bearing? A girl stood in the road cause about to... Thank you. I nearly missed that. You think that's how the first accident was made? The hell, man. So in this game, you gotta pay attention to the littlest things. The stuff like, I don't know, that story with the chip. And sober might be relevant later on. We don't know. Hey, come on.
You know I hate it when you don't take the things I say seriously.
Come on, sweetheart, I do. I just had a rough day today.
Can you believe they are at each other again? I can.
You're drunk. What a surprise.
I just caught the game with the guys, honey. That's it.
That's not it. Never is.
There's talk. Some of us may be losing our jobs. The factory...
You've been saying that for years. I'm more worried about Megan.
What's wrong with Megan? She looks okay to me.
Everything looks okay after 10 beers.
Even you.
Reverend Carson held her back after prayers today. That's 4 weeks running. She's not right. It's serious, James.
You worry too much about that kid. I can't deal with this right now.
Another surprise. You can't deal with anything. When would be the right time?
You're making a mountain out of a molehill. Getting yourself worked up for nothing.
For nothing? Single-handedly keeping our family together
Sam.
Is far from nothing in my book. I could use a little help.
Maybe if we'd had kids of our own, none of this would be happening.
That's a real low blow. Don't you get how tough this
You're not
is
the
for
only
me?
One feels pressure. The factory situation is serious, Anne. Real serious. Not right now. Not tonight. No way.
Clark family late. Home.
She always is these days.
Okay, I'm not gonna mouth off anyone just yet. I don't think it really matters.
Why
at the
is
moment.
This here? Only released last year. Even a no-taste hardhead like you will appreciate this. Going to be huge. Hey, Bigfoot, mind the goddamn vinyl, will ya?
Say nothing.
Christ, you're like a kid possessed. Your head'll start spinning around in a minute.
I'm going to start climbing through the window unless that door gets fixed. How's things? Let me guess. He's been pumping iron again?
They've been at each other's throats since Dad got home.
What's it about this time?
Dad's been drinking some dad we got. Disappointed always hurts more.
He nearly fell through the front door. Some dad we got, huh?
They're always fighting these days, getting predictable, like a record that keeps playing over and over.
Dennis, for the 10 millionth time, will you shift that shit of yours up into the attic?
Some respect. This is a valuable, rare, and sought-after collection. I think she was a Marine sergeant in a past life.
What's crawled up his ass?
He is being a jerk.
He's being even more annoying than usual tonight. A real jerk.
So what else is new?
Hey, Dennis. Hey!
Not now, sis. I'm busy.
He's not wearing any shoes or anything. Oh, she's gonna kill
hey.
Him.
Quit acting crazy!
Oh, you fucking kid! Why the fuck do you do that to me?
Jesus!
I know, right?
You scared me, sweetheart.
I heard you talking about me.
Not now, Megan. I'd like to have a bath in peace. Take a break from this madhouse for a while.
Everyone rejecting her. Poor kid. Are you the one I nearly ran over? Oh shit.
Maybe you should talk to Mom and Dad.
It's not a great idea for me to get involved. You know what I'm like? I just upset someone.
This sounded more serious than the usual bullshit. They were talking about Megan. She's done something bad.
I can't say I'm surprised. There's definitely something off with Megan.
I don't get why everyone keeps picking on her.
Okay, Mr. Shining Knight in Armor. Where's the little princess anyway?
Well, why aggressive? Why do we have to leave Megan alone? I don't know.
Probably better to leave Megan alone.
As her big sister, it is my sworn legal duty to check in on her.
Right, sure. Like you're the law around here. She went upstairs.
I'll go find her.
That's the eyebrow character, right? The eyebrow actor. I don't know his name. He's just known as the eyebrow actor. The one who's also a meme. Press to pick up, move to examine, and press to put down. Okay. Press in time with heartbeat button may change. Sure. Yeah, we had this in the other game too.
Right back to Brian Watson. He pulls and is blocked by Green on a big play, and out comes Watson. Here's a lead pass, Edison in alone. He drives and Robert saves. Coming up 15 feet to bring it up.
Was that not right?
Keep an eye on your little sister. Mom is real worried about her.
Sure.
It's okay, Dad. 10 years checking on her right now.
You want to try raising a family like this? The devil himself would struggle with you guys.
Press to move to a location. Press to stop moving. Press at screen edges to move in that direction. Well, that's clearly not working. What happened to the good old WASD days? Why do I have to click shit now? What the hell is X? Let's go in here. And then over here. Okay, I'm not enjoying this. I really prefer the WASD stuff. Now it's just a clicky clicky. Shroud of Innocence.
Perfect distraction from this madhouse.
A must read for anyone with an interest in the Salem witch trials of 1682. I guess it's a little bit of a foreshadowing, telling us that our sister may be a witch. Move to examine, exit. There may be hidden information. Like, really. Takes a bit of getting used to. Still not entirely sure how to move the damn thing, but. Is there hidden information there? If there is, I ain't seen none. New England witch trials. Some more foreshadowing. I don't know if I have to like check on the sister or something. Good. How about this one? Nope. Megan Clark. Number of days present. Days absent. Days tardy. Damn, that's a lot of tardy days.
Anthony, where are you, goddammit? Anthony, I'm getting really pissed off! Anthony, I swear if you don't answer me!
You could be right about my family. I think so too.
Oh, hell no.
Tanya, what's going on?
That little brat locked me out. It's fucking freezing!
Oh, hell.
I'll let you back in. Go easy on Megan. Hold on.
You're locked out now, aren't you? Oh, shit.
Shit!
Mom's
Megan!
Locked in the...
You in there?
Dad's probably asleep. The dude's in the attic. Everyone's gonna die.
The kitchen's on fire!
Are you fucking serious?
Megan? Dad? Dennis? Mom? Where the hell is everybody?
Anthony! Help!
Jump! 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 Seriously, jump! Pick a window and jump. Everyone can do that.
Help!
Anthony! Hey! Up here!
What the fuck are you doing up there?
I got trapped in the attic.
Get to the balcony!
Anthony, help!
Dude, I would have smashed a window down ages ago. Do I have to choose now? You have got to be... You've got to be kidding me, right? Okay, so the kid's a demon. The kid is not going to die anyway, so I should be saving the sister on the balcony. But if I save the sister on the balcony, the demon is going to resent me and fucking kill me later on. So I'm going to save... Just keep it interesting. I'm going to save the one on the balcony. Because the demon is going to survive. Oh my god! Usually I would save the child, but considering that she's being followed by a demon, assertive.
Get to the drain pipe and climb down!
I would feel a lot more comfortable if she died anyway, because that way I know both of them will die. Are you kidding me? What is this, Final Destination? There's still one more brother. Oh my god, what the actual fuck was that? Copyright, gonna mute this part. Okay, that was disturbing as shit. Okay, so every decision that we made was completely irrelevant. I guess that was just like an introduction so that we get a little feel of the game. So that we know what to press, how to walk, and ooh. That was some Final Destination shit, and I do not appreciate that. I could never watch any of the Final Destinations. That's too much gore for me. And too, you know, circumstantial. That was weird as shit. So what was up with the little girl? If she was genuinely like, I don't know if she was possessed or if a demon was just following her, then why did she die? Why did demon choose to kill her as well? I genuinely thought she would survive either way because she's got, you know, the ghost to save her. It's a pretty good song, so I'm kind of sorry that you're not allowed to hear it. So you again. I liked you, if I remember correctly.
Hello.
Hi.
And welcome back. I have a new story for you.
Ooh.
It's very different to the last.
I like what he's wearing. I like his hair. Oh. Love his hair. My hair's too Asian for that. I can't do that.
Disconcerting, no? I'm sure there's nothing to worry about. This particular story isn't fully fleshed out. It's only part written, and the choices you make will complete it. The fire. No, there was nothing you could have done about that. What's happened has happened. Or has it? Anyway, look to the future, I say. Life's but a walking shadow, eh? You are about to enter a confusing, perhaps disturbing world. How disturbing might depend on what you choose to believe. And how confusing on the path you choose to take. There are an infinite number of directions in which one could travel. We seldom have all the information that we'd like, but we have to choose our path nonetheless and hope that we get the clarity and the outcomes that we want. As in life, your decisions will matter. The choices you make will affect others. You've seen how the story starts. So much death. How many more deaths is entirely up to you. It depends on the decisions that you make.
Oh, God.
What are you? Rational? Emotional? Do you trust your head or your heart? There is no right answer. Sometimes one is best and sometimes the other. My advice, for what it's worth, is to thine own self be true.
No regrets, basically.
But I'm here simply to record what you do, not to help you. I'm not supposed to interfere, you see. Not my place, apparently. But I am apparently allowed to share wise words from great storytellers that have gone before, where I feel that that would be appropriate. Oh, one final thing before I let you go. There are pictures in Little Hope, that will, if found, show you a vision of a possible future, something that may or may not happen. Use them. They might help you. You have a funeral to attend. Off you go. Have fun.
I remember those pictures. I think they kind of helped. But it's difficult to like see the picture and actually recognize it when it's happening in real time, I think. But that was a good intro. I like it when he does his talk. So intimidating, yet comforting.
None of us here today can understand why this tragic accident happened. But we can take comfort from the knowledge that the family are together for eternity in God's loving embrace.
Andrew, 18, college student, anxious, detached. Taylor, 22, college student, headstrong, sensitive. John, 43, college professor, rational, overbearing.
Where the hell's Daniel? I can't find him.
I don't know.
Daniel. Unknown. Missing.
Instead of goofing around, you want to lend a hand here?
Sure.
How is he doing anyway?
It doesn't look that serious. Could be concussed.
Okay, perfect.
I don't know what the character relationships actually have to do with the decisions that I make. I don't know if it actually, you know, swerves off into a different storyline.
Or should I call you doctor now?
Why don't you try calling for help? Maybe the cops, someone like that.
I'm on it.
I already tried once, but I'm on it.
Hey, Andrew, buddy, how you doing?
Where are we? What happened?
Yeah, the bus crashed. We're okay, though, just shaken up.
If you say so. I don't remember being in any crash.
You're probably in shock. Maybe a mild concussion in there, too. Give yourself some time. Stay here. Don't move.
He looks like the kid from just now, right?
Fucking thing, useless piece of crap! May as well be dead.
Okay, take it easy. We'll figure out what to do.
Is this Daniel? Daniel, 20, college student, amiable, and defensive. Oh, you are a lovable boy. Angela, 48, mature student, abrasive, understanding.
Hey, anyone up there?
Hey, Daniel, that you?
John, good to hear you.
Daniel?
Taylor, you okay?
I'm good.
We're fine too, thanks for asking. You okay down there?
I'm all right, nothing I can't deal with.
Hey, John, any idea what caused the crash?
Not sure. Looked like the driver swerved to avoid something in the road. He down there, by the way?
Nope. No sign of him.
Weird. He isn't up here either. Can you get back up to us?
Looks pretty steep. I see a trail down here I could try.
Great. Take the trail.
should take you to the road. We can regroup there.
That's a plan. See you soon.
Bitch, I'd be climbing.
Hey, Taylor, help me get Andrew up on his feet, will ya?
Wait, I don't remember anything. Who are you?
It's okay. You're concussed. I'm John, you're a college professor. We were taking a bus on a field trip, but that didn't work out so well. Crash wasn't on the curriculum. We'll find the others, get some help. Think of it as a character building exercise.
Point and press before the timer runs out.
Teamwork at its finest.
I had this dream. It was so real. Flames all around us. It was grim.
That bang on the head must have been a beauty.
That trail the others are on will come out down the road. We'll meet them there.
Why leave the bus? Do as he says, man. Don't break up. Stay together.
Why can't we stay here?
No. We could be here all night. Our best move is to get to the others, then head towards town. See if we can find some help.
Where's the driver? Shouldn't he be back by now?
The driver's done what we should be doing. Gone into town for help.
We don't know. We really don't know where he went, but I don't want to be an aggressive bitch in this situation, so...
You're right. Let's go. I'm with you.
I'm right.
The quicker we get help, the quicker we can all go home.
Stick close behind me.
What the hell did that do? Taylor agreed with John's plan to head into town. Yeah, cooperation, okay? Foundation of every civilization. Let's move to the location, okay. I'm playing as... Your name was...
Taking off like that and ditching us?
Maybe you didn't realize. Could just be in shock.
We're his responsibility, his passengers. He can't just stroll off.
What am I looking at there? I'm with that. That. Crash? That. Oh, the skull's there, dude. The hell's that? That's a fucking... That's a thing. That's that symbol. That's that symbol. You see that symbol? Oh, shit. How do I look down, for the love of God? I hate my life. I genuinely hate my life. There you go. See that? Can somebody please comment on that?
You're kidding me. Now what? Looks like something out of a creepy horror movie.
I know.
Actually, you're nearly right. I've seen stuff like this in books. It's there to ward off evil spirits.
Jesus. This really is a night full of nightmares.
That's beautiful. Okay, I'm not liking this steering, man. I don't like this clicky stuff. Unreadable, abandoned hope. That's nice.
You know this place? Little Hope?
No. I mean, I don't think so.
You should both know Little Hope.
Why?
Why should I have heard of this place?
Seriously, this place is steeped in history. Fascinating stuff.
How do you know all this stuff anyway?
I'm a professional academic. I read books, unlike some.
Okay,
easy,
calm down.
Easy, Einstein. I can match everything you got with just a smartphone.
Well, your phone isn't so smart without a signal.
Your phone isn't so smart without a signal.
Good to see you two, finally. Everything okay?
Sure. We took the scenic route.
You sure as hell took your own sweet time. I was getting worried.
I bet you were.
This gate is chained. We can't get through.
Look around. See if there's anything we can use to break it.
Think this'll do it?
Ready? I'll push hard from my side.
Ready. 3, 2, 1. Ooh. Push!
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about!
Great job, you two.
What's the plan now?
Head into town, see if we can get help.
You know where town is?
Sure, we're near Little Hope.
Sounds like a fun place.
Funnily enough, Little Hope does have an interesting and dark history.
Say nothing, I want to hear it.
Bad things happened here a long time ago.
Which you are dying to tell us all about.
I'm starting not to like you or your attitude.
I'm not even started yet. You want a little more?
Try to be civil. Cost nothing.
That's rich, given how you badmouth Taylor on the way over.
What did she say about me?
Oh, shit.
You always get your boyfriend to stick up for you? Try doing it yourself sometime, dear.
Oh my damn, what is up here? I'm not wasting any breath on you. Let's be grown up about this.
Well, that certainly shut you up.
Okay, I'll fuck
you. Quit it, will you? The last thing we need is you causing trouble.
Keep out of our business, okay?
We are wasting valuable time here. Can we please just keep moving?
You think this is a solid plan, heading into town?
As good as any.
I went along with it before, but I'm not so sure now.
So what do you want to do?
How about you come with me back to the bus?
Okay.
I still think the smart move is for us all to stick together.
You'll be glad we didn't stick together after we flagged down a car and come rescue your ass.
Not so smart.
You get lost?
What the fuck?
We're back here?
This doesn't add up. This is some very weird shit going on here.
Spare us all. First he loses his pride, then he loses his way.
What are you trying to say?
That you've lost it.
It's not possible.
Look, I don't know what you're trying to prove here, but we've got better things to do.
Daniel?
Whoa.
Hey, careful!
Watch out!
Quit fucking around and tell me what's going on here.
The two of us will go together.
This is getting ridiculous.
Indulge me. Right. We walked dead straight going away from you. So, how'd we end up back here?
Okay, let's try something. We'll all go together. We came from that direction. We must be able to go back that way. I want everyone to stay real close. No stragglers.
You want to put us on a kid's line?
Fuck you.
Okay, I'm coming.
You better. There's always a bitch in the group. Every one of these games. Until Dawn had one. The last game, I think, had one. We're back here, right?
I admit, that is a little odd.
You people are not concerned enough.
See? What did I tell you?
It's just like I've been saying, we are trapped! We can't leave here! Now
okay.
What can we do?
Calm down. Breathe. There's a rational explanation for what's happening.
Maybe we all died in the crash.
Yeah, nice theory, but I'm pretty sure we're all still alive and kicking.
Last I checked, you were schooling us on creative writing, not metaphysics.
I know who I'd like to be kicking. This is all down to you, this pissy little field trip. Now we're stuck here in Little No Hope.
That is way out of line. I had no way of knowing that damn bus would crash. You can't put that on me.
Are you for fucking real?
Watch your tone, will you? I am doing my best to understand this, just like you and the rest of us.
Let's just... Yeah, you gotta apologize.
Sorry. Though. I don't get what's happening to us. I don't understand. It's like you said, we're trapped in a nightmare.
It's okay. We're gonna be just fine. We'll figure a way out of this together.
Someone else thinks they can do a better job. Step right up.
Maybe it isn't real.
We have to get out of here right
now. I need to think straight.
Football
coaching.
Why the fuck?
Can everyone just shut up?
This isn't helping us find help or getting us out of here.
He's right. Bitching at each other isn't getting us anywhere. We have to work together as a team.
Thank you.
Now let's be logical. The fog is between us and the bus. There is no fog between us and town, so let's head that way.
I don't get how heading further away from the bus helps.
There is nothing on the bus we can use to get help. In town, there will be people, a working phone, something.
It pains me to admit, but he's right. There's nowhere else we can go except into that damn town.
Sounds like a plan to me.
You leaving me? Where are you going?
Come on, let's go with them. Until we know what's up, we should stick together.
She's been a little bit difficult. A little bit stubborn. And I think I'm gonna end it there, ladies and gentlemen, boys. Okay, so the game before this, Man of Medan, had a similar timeline where you start off the game in the past and then something happens, something very shocking, and then there's like a time jump to the present. It's basically what happened here, and it's just interesting. And for those of you, okay, no, I'm not gonna spoil it. Just in case anyone who hasn't seen the first game, I'm not gonna spoil it for you. But the ending will always be good. Okay, so I'm gonna end here, ladies and gentlemen. I hope to see you on the next video. Take care. Have a very, very nice Halloween. I will see you soon. Take care. Bye bye. Stay safe. And I love you very much.